in the line, they put me in the center. It blow their mind when they see how I'm winning. Went back and doubled up, now you in trouble. My I'll hustle, my diamonds are huddled up. TGOD got this off the muscle. Ask me about my life, man. I love it, I love it. Got so many rings, I need room for another one. Been through the pain, now it ain't no more struggle. My team win the game, put our face on the cover, brother. We the champions.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League comes to you from Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, Michigan. Straight ahead, we've got a goal between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Detroit Lions. Just about time to rock as Toe gets ready to meet leather. And we are underway from Ford Field. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line. So a net negative there of 4 yards.
Here we go. Good enough.
Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And he'll manage to pick up about 4 at second down.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. He'll pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you could do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Back to Mixon on second down. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. Just got a whole lot of room to operate on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job standing in their pocket places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From the shotgun, it's Burrow. That one taken in by T. Higgins. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. They give him 27 yards on the third down conversion. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. Aiden Hutchinson. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. The job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage. But that's it. No gain on the play this time. But it'll be a third-down situation coming out. Burrow looking to pass. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
On fourth down, Drew Chrisman on to punt.
So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And the Lions are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10.
Goff and this Lions offense set for a first and 10
at their own 15.
On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 25. Giving 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1.
Once again, it's Swift. And this will wind up a Lions first down as he'll get this out to about the 42.
You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game. And it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And he'll go down, but not before getting us inside the 30. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. What a great effort there. He's going to get this inside the 15, and he'll spot it at the 13-yard line. Nice run. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. No score after one on EA Sports. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Goff a handoff here to Swift. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. The last run got a couple here, second and 8. Here's Goff. Quick hitter here, it's complete. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And now it's 3rd and 3.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. That has to feel like a very unsatisfying drive, right? You move the ball all that way and then you can't convert on third down.
But it was satisfying up until that point. Almost like a great movie, and then the film cuts out before the big ending.
Here we go on fourth. Goff. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. 4 minutes to play here in quarter number 2. They begin with a run by Mixon, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
And that's frustrating for our defense because they've got to put him down deep. And on the first play, they give up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
62 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. So they had it bottled up, able to make a man miss, and then boom, off to the races.
And it's how he made him miss. A little bit of strength, too. Had to work through contact to get him off of him. And then once he did that, now he put his agility to use and took off.
And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
And that's a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync. And the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
On second down, here's Mixon. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get it behind the line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up the 3rd down.
People talk about plays being blown up. That's exactly what they're talking about. That's exhibit A for physical play.
And the pressure gets there. He'll go down. It's a sack. It's going to bring us to the 2-minute warning. Aiden Hutchinson in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning.
I'm wondering.
Burrow going for it on 4th. Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase complete. And he is going to have the Bengals 1st down as they pick up a big chunk of yards to boot. 18 of them.
Brandon, I have one word for you after that completion for a 1st down.
Lucky?
Analytics.
Well, the analytics say it punt the football there.
So we're changing the analytics as we go, right? What a big-time play for them, and really took a big-time chance.
Yeah, big-time first-half chance. Here we go now on 1st and goal. Now Burrow. And he's got it. A gain of 7 that time. 2nd goal.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. It's a 1-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with him trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Throwing again on second down. Goff connecting here with DJ Shark. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Play action. It's Goff. Caught. It's St. Brown. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. Badgley able to punch this one through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Maybe a moral victory of sorts. They're on the board here late in the first half, but this offense just hasn't looked that sharp.
Yeah, but at least they got the 3 points, right? At least they have something to, quote-unquote, hang their hats on and maybe feel a little bit better about themselves as they head to the half.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30. The Bengals drive about to get going. And with a 7-3 lead, we'll see how aggressive they want to be. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda. And the Lions are going to take possession of the football. Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
Badgley's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And that is not going to get it done either. Once again, he's stopped behind the line by this Bengals D. Goff wants to throw on third and long. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he is going to have the Lions first down, and comfortably so, as he gets 5 yards on third of the yard.
Certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
On first and 10, it's Swift, and he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about 5.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down, because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And some room to maneuver. And they will finally get to him down at the Bengals 15. 81 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Got to give a nod of appreciation to some of those guys up front on that left side. Several key blocks sprung here.
No appreciation for the guys from the backside that didn't allow any leakage, and anybody could run him down from the backside.
They're at the kids' table.
Okay, so front side guys, backside guys.
Nah.
That's what you're supposed to do.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Amon-Ra St. Brown, the 15-yard touchdown run. And the Lions have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive in the second half. Dan Campbell makes the call. His guys will go for two here. They'll try to run with Swift, and he will find the end zone here. And the lead moves up to 7. And they're able to ground it in there on the two-point try. And you know, we're talking before the game. The two-point conversions from the 15-16 season, what has changed, what hasn't changed, partner?
Yeah, I'll tell you what's changed is just your normal strategy, because now you're either kicking the football with the ball on the 15-yard line, or if you decide to go for two, they put it on the 2-yard line. So what are you thinking as a coach? Do I risk it? Do I go for it here? Do I try and gain a strategic advantage and maybe go for two early? That's what people are wondering about.
They'll try to get the run game going. This is Mixon. They find some open field here. And some nifty running here as they'll take this across midfield and down to the 47.
Here we go. 13 yards. And the Bengals first down.
Back to Mixon on first down. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
And we often talk about defensive end setting the edge, sometimes even the outside linebackers, but how about here? This is a quarterback essentially setting the edge and finishing off that play for a loss.
Here's Burrow completing this to Chase, and it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 25-yard line. Final minute now in the third quarter. Mixon with a first down carry. Michael Brockers in on the stop.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and 9. Burrow. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion as well. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw as well.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. This is caught, it's Boyd. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. It'll be first and goal when we come back. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports.
On one, right?
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down seven. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. And give him five that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown.
Joe Mixon,
his second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And an important one that is, as we are all tied now early in this fourth quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown, all tied up in the fourth quarter, and a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. They'll stay on the ground with Swift, and he'll be upended here after a pickup of three, getting it out to the 25.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. They'll fake the handoff. Now Goff. Complete to right. And he is going to have a Lions first down. It's a gain of six that time on third and two.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because there should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Back to the air. Goff on second down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
They'll try and set up the screen to Swift.
And he's going to be taken down at the 39, clearly short of first by a few yards. They go ahead and snap it. Gone. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he is going to have the Lions first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. 2 first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Gone. Looking for White and he finds him. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. So first and 10 now from the 30. Swift gonna try up the middle. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Second down and 8. They run out of the gun with Swift. And he's able to motor his way down to his 16-yard line. 102 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. They will run straight ahead with Swift. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
14 more yards. That's another Detroit Lions first down. First
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
Here's Swift, and he's in for the touchdown. And in the final seconds, forget overtime. They just likely won this thing in regulation. Some good running there at the end of the drive. He had the burst that set up the first and goal, and then one play later, he's in the end zone.
Brandon, what I liked about that sequence is I'm not sure who made the play call, but they understood the situation, understood the momentum. A nice hard-charging run. Give it right back to him and let him cap things off.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. Just outside the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drives. Oh, that's going to be a costly one. It's intercepted. Picked off by Amani Oruwariye, and the Lions are going to take possession of the football.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
From the gun, here's Swift. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses this game.